In this video, we'll show you how to train the following clustering algorithms in KNIME. K-means, hierarchical clustering, DBSCAN. In this demonstration, we'll cluster the iris dataset based on four numerical features that describe each iris. Before we train each clustering algorithm, we normalize the features into the range 0 to 1 with a normalizer node. After clustering, we denormalize the data back to the original range with a denormalizer node. We start with the k-means algorithm. In the configuration dialog of the k-means node, we define the number of clusters k, 3 for example, and the clustering columns. Optionally, we can define whether the initial clusters are the first k rows or random rows. We can also set the maximum number of iterations here, that is, how many times the clusters are recalculated after the initial clustering. The k-means node has three outputs. The first output shows the cluster assignment of each row in the input data. The second output shows the column values at the cluster centers. The third output is the clustering model, which we can use to apply the same clustering model to new data. In addition, we evaluate the clustering numerically with the select coefficient statistics. It compares the distance within a cluster to a distance between clusters. The select coefficient node calculates the statistics for each row separately, and also an overall value as their average. The closer the overall value is to 1, the more compact and separated the clusters are. We can also optimize the number of clusters based on the select coefficient with the optimized k-means select coefficient component. In its configuration dialog, we select the minimum number of clusters, the maximum number of iterations, the step size, and the clustering columns. Here we start from 2 clusters and apply maximum 5 iterations with a step size 1. This means 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 clusters will be tested. We could also change the optimization strategy from brute force to hill climbing. The first output of the component shows the select coefficient for the varying number of clusters. In this case, the best number of clusters is 2 because it produces the highest select coefficient. The remaining outputs of the component corresponds to the outputs of the k-means node for the optimized k. Next, we perform hierarchical clustering. The first option is to use a hierarchical clustering node. In its configuration dialog, we define the number of clusters as 3, select Euclidean distance as the distance function, and complete linkage as the linkage type. The output of the node shows the input data plus a cluster column for the cluster assignment of each row. The second option is to use the hierarchical clustering and heat map component and determine the number of clusters visually in a dendrogram. In its configuration dialog, we only select the clustering columns. The component applies a complete linkage type and Euclidean distance by default. The interactive view of the component shows a heat map and a dendrogram of the hierarchical clusters. The y-axis indicates the distance between the connected clusters. If we move the line up, clusters will be joined into fewer but more sparse clusters. If we move it down, clusters will be split into multiple more compact clusters. In addition, we can click on the cluster in a dendrogram and see in a heat map which rows belong to the cluster. The color coding in each column indicates how similar the rows are. To apply the clustering that is currently selected in the dendrogram, we select Close and Apply here in the bottom right corner. Finally, we perform DBSCAN clustering. The DBSCAN node takes 2 inputs, a data table, and the distance matrix of the clustering columns, which we can calculate with the numeric distances node. In the configuration dialog of the DBSCAN node, we define 2 settings, epsilon as the radius of a neighborhood and minimum points at the required density of a neighborhood. Notice that the number of clusters is not defined beforehand. The first output table of the DBSCAN node shows the cluster assignment of each row. The second output table shows the frequency distribution of the clusters and noise points. To conclude, let's compare the scatter plots and the select coefficients of the algorithms in this interactive view. The optimized k-means clustering separates the data into the upper and lower clouds. The hierarchical clustering method creates compact but poorly separated clusters because the complete linkage method was selected. The DBSCAN clustering produces an almost identical clustering to the optimized k-means clustering, except for this noise point here. This table below shows the select coefficients, and it is the highest for the optimized k-means clustering. Notice though, the best clustering always depends on your use case and preference. In this video, we have demonstrated the k-means, hierarchical, and DBSCAN clustering in KNIME. We have compared the three methods on the iris data, and we have shown that the different methods produce different types of clusters.